Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. So to understand more about electrochemistry, we should understand what are the terms involved in electrochemistry. So because of which we could derive many much more derivation and we could study more about it. So let us study. So let me first of all talk about resistance. Resistance is the main factor because of which electricity is being measured. It is a physical property, but now we are going to study in chemistry. And what does it say? Let us see. Resistance means the electrical resistance of an electrical conductor is defined as the opposition to the passage of electric current through the conductor. The opposition that is faced by the current through the conductor is known as resistance. And if the resistance have to be increased, if we have to increase the resistance, then we have to increase the length of the conductor. And we have to shorten the area of the cross section of the conductor from which the current is been passing. So for that instance, we have a formula as resistance is directly proportional to the length of the conductor, which means if the resistance has to be increased, then the length of the conductor should be increased. And it is inversely proportional to capital A. In this case, the capital A is nothing but the area of the cross section of the conductor that we are using or through which the electricity, the current is being passed. So this proportionality can be equated by R is equals to rho into L upon A. This rho is nothing but the resistivity that we are going to learn. So now what would be the unit of resistance? The unit of resistance is nothing but ohm. So this is the unit of the resistance, and we have also learned that what is resistance and what is the unit of it. So now let us see what does this symbol means, or what does this rho means. Rho is nothing but the resistivity. And what is resistivity? It is the resistance of the conductor that is 1 meter long and 1 meter square area of cross section. So since we have got to know the formula of the resistance, which is now can be written as rho is equals to R into A divided by L, where A is the area of cross section and L is the length of the conductor. So suppose when will be the resistivity, that is rho, will be equal to R? It will be only possible if the area of cross section, that is A, is 1 meter square and the length of the conductor that we are using, they are is and the length of the conductor that we are using, that is 1 meter. So because of which, now then only this rho and this R will be equal to each other. So this is how we can determine that what is resistivity of a particular conductor by making the conductor's length as 1 meter and by making the area of cross section as 1 meter square. And for different materials, the resistivity as well as the resistance are different. So this is how we can determine what is resistivity. Now let us move towards the next one. So now we are going to learn about conductance. So what is conductance? It is the inverse of the resistance. So for that instance, what we could write is, it is expressed as G. And since it is inverse of the resistance, so we could get a formula as G is equals to I 1 upon R, because it is the reciprocal of the resistance. So if G is equals to 1 upon R, then what would be the unit of this thing? So see, the unit of the conductance will be, since this unit of resistance is ohms, so I could write it as ohm inverse for the conductance. So this ohm inverse can be also written as Siemens, that we are going to learn more, much more about it in the future. So since this has been elaborated, so now let us see what does conductivity means. So conductivity is nothing but it is the inverse of the resistivity, similar to which we have learned right now, that if conductance is the inverse of the resistance, then conductivity will be the inverse of the resistivity, or resistivity can also be said as specific resistance of a particular material. So this conductivity can also be said as specific conductance of a particular material or a particular solution. So it is the inverse of the resistivity. It is represented by kappa. This K can be also said as kappa. So since this is the inverse of the resistivity, that is kappa is equals to 1 upon rho, and this rho can be written as R into A divided by L. So we have elaborated in this way. So but we have also right now have got to know that 1 upon R, that is the reciprocal of the resistance, is nothing but the conductance. So therefore 1 upon R is equals to G into L, that is length of the conductor, and A is the area of the cross section of the conductor. So this is equated in this form. So what would be the unit of this thing? So before knowing that what would be the unit of this thing, so this can be defined as, so the conductivity can be defined as the conductance of a material of 1 meter length and having 1 meter square area of cross section. So this is conductivity. Conductivity, as we have seen, when the length is 1 meter and while the area of cross section is 1 meter square. So therefore, when K is equals to G, that is equals to conductance, it will only be possible if the length and the area are of unit length as well as of unit cross section. So since we know the unit of the conductance as ohm inverse, so therefore we could write the unit of kappa as also ohm inverse, but the length is has a unit of meter, or we could write it in centimeter, while the area has a unit of meter square, or we could write it as centimeter square. So for that instance, what I could write it in this way as, the conductivity, which has a formula of K is equals to G into L upon A. Therefore, since the unit of G is ohm inverse, the unit of length can be written as centimeter, or you could write it in a CGS unit, or you could write it in SI unit. But the thing that we are going to learn in the whole electrochemistry in this chapter, that we are going to use the CGS unit, because the apparatus that we are using or the concentration that we are using, it they all are present in CGS unit. So for that instance, we could write in, the, in this way as the length, which has a unit of centimeter, while the area, which has a unit of centimeter square, which means this will cancel out each other, and the thing that will be remaining with us is ohm inverse centimeter inverse. So this is the unit of the conductivity. So by this we have got to know that is what is conductivity and what is the unit of conductivity, and how they are related to each other with the conductance and the resistance also. So now let's move towards the next one, that is molar conductivity. What is molar conductivity? For that we have to know what is the definition of molar conductivity, and it says that the conductance of a volume of a solution that contains 1 mole of a dissolved electrolyte when placed between 2 parallel electrodes that are 1 centimeter apart and large enough to contain between them all the solution. So basically, molar conductivity is basically a conductivity for 1 molar solution. So that could also be written as, it is represented by the symbol capital lambda. And for that instance, we should know that the capital lambda is equals to the conductivity divided by C. In this case, kappa is conductivity while C is the concentration of the solution for which we have to calculate the molar conductivity. So for that thing, we have got the unit as ohm inverse centimeter square and mole inverse. This mole inverse is nothing but the concentrations unit. So this is how we have calculated or we have determined what are the definition or what are the terms of which are based on electrochemistry, as well as what are the units of this term. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please don't forget to share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeda channel. Thank you so much.